Former head coach Norm Chow addressed his players moments ago. Ben Clarke, the captain, speaking.
The past couple losses, but no, nothing official. He didn't know.
Ben, what was the mood like inside that meeting? I know you've been asked this, but were there tears? I mean, what was the message that Coach Chow sent?
It was a happy message, I guess. He talked about how none of us should be sad about it. Like, it's college coaching is a tough job, and he's been fired before. He made that clear, and it's not the end of the world. He told us to keep our heads up and keep playing.
Like you said, how do you go forward with these next four games?
Just doing our best to win. I mean, the seniors, like me included, would like to go out on a high note, and then for everyone else, getting a couple of wins before heading into spring ball and everything will be really important.
Ben, something that you know maybe more than your position players, Chris has this tough love kind of coaching style. What are you telling the other boys about, you know, how to approach it when he basically is in your face yelling at you?
I mean, I think they know a little bit about it because they've been out there, or at least the offensive guys do. I don't think there's any special way you need to approach it. You just need to take it as he comes.
But something
Ben,
you know,
Clarke talking a little bit about Chris Naoli, the interim head coach. And so what's happened is there's a meeting this morning, Coach Chow telling his players basically sort of an exit the meeting, if you will, telling them goodbye. As you heard Ben Clarke saying, telling the kids that not to feel sad about this, that things do happen. This is a major college sport, and that he's been fired before. Now, later this morning, we're hoping to hear from University of Hawaii Athletics Director David Matlin about the change. We're also going to hear from another player as well, just about the mood and how they move forward with this. As we said, Chris Naoli will now be the interim acting head coach, but the search is now open for a head coach. As Ben Clarke was saying, the offensive lineman, there are four more games that they have to play at Las Vegas this next weekend, and then three more home games to close out the 2015 season. During his tenure as the University of Hawaii head football coach, Norm Chow able to just muster 10 wins against 36 losses. And so now, this is also going to be a costly thing. Just within the last few weeks, with the former University of Hawaii basketball coach Gib Arnold being let go, and that costing nearly $1.1 million to the University of Hawaii system when you add in legal fees, when you add in the buyout clause and that sort of thing. Coach Chow had another remaining year. And obviously, there's a buyout clause that's involved in that. We're going to be asking those difficult questions to David Matlin a little later on this morning, and we'll bring you an update to this story, this developing story, here on KH12 Wake Up Today, as well as online at KH12.com. All right, back in our Wake Up Today studio.
Thank you very much, Jai. Declining season ticket holders became an issue at the end of the day, became a declining attendance. 15,000 people watched that last game. 7,000 people who had tickets chose not to come to the football game on Halloween night.
I was also interested to hear what Ben Clarke was saying about Coach Chow's message. So, sounded positive.
Yes, indeed.
Best you could do.
Yep.
Right now, we're going to go to Need to Know before you head out the door this morning. Lifeguards checking on Waikiki Beach this morning to determine if it's safe to remove warning signs after a shark was spotted near Old Man's yesterday afternoon.
Three westbound lanes of the H1 freeway closed in the Pearl City area tonight and again tomorrow night for pavement work. The closures begin at 9 p.m. and continue to 4:30 in the morning.
All lanes of Kamehameha Highway will be closed in both directions overnight today through Friday in Mililani between Ka'uku Boulevard and Lanikuhana Avenue.
Crews begin rockfall mitigation work today on the hillside behind Hanama Bay, expected to take 3 months to complete. And I understand Dave Matlin, AD, is now speaking. We will join Jai live once again in Manoa.
And put us in a position where we can compete.
Cost, because we're dealing also just within the last few weeks with Gib Arnold, and that costing almost $1.1 million as far as legal fees and that sort of thing. What is it going to cost now moving forward with Coach Chow?
Well, Norm's buyout is $200,000 for the fifth year, and there's a three-month notice over plus 90 days, you know, approximately $140,000 for his buyout. There's other costs associated with a staff turnover and transition, but until we know what the new staff is and who's going to be retained, I can't really speculate on the exact amount.
Did you get a chance to talk to players? What was their attitude like?
I just spoke with the players before I came in here about finishing up the rest of the season. They're very resilient. They'll continue to play hard. You know, yesterday wasn't a joyous day. I mean, I think some people don't realize that there's a human side to this. Coaches and their families. This impacts a lot of people's lives, and there's no joy in that. But I think sometimes you make decisions that you believe are in the best interest. But I think players realize that. Overall, I was proud of they seem in a good place.
Moving forward, the next coach. When does the process start?
Well, we posted the job yesterday. We posted the job yesterday, and it's a five-day post, which is accelerated. But we'll probably roll it, because probably we won't have the best pool until after the season's over. So a lot of people might not want to apply until it's over. So it's ongoing right now, but I wouldn't expect anything before the season ends for us to be able to start interviewing just because of that. But we want to be prepared just in case we do get enough applicants where we can go.
Will it be the same pay range, or are you going to try to up it a little bit?
I think it depends on the candidate pool. I don't really have a specific answer on that. We obviously we have some limitations on what we can do, but as far as what we it ends up being, I think it depends on the pool.
Are you going to reach out to some candidates, or are you just going to wait for them to apply?
I think if people want to apply for the job and they're interested, I think they need to send us to fill out our application.
But not send out your own search committee to look for.
We're not hiring a search committee and.
Being funded internally, or.
People will reach out. People will reach out to us, and we'll respond to those, with if you're interested, please apply.
David, can you tell us about the decision to make Chris the interim head coach?
Yeah, well, Chris is the associate head coach. I think Chris will command respect to the players. We have a one world trip left, and as well as three games left. I feel we felt Chris was the most equipped guy to do it. He also has probably he's been here the longest, so he's got a feel for the players. He's been here as when a lot of them recruited, and I think that's important.
Mr. Matlin, with 15,000 or so at the stadium on Saturday night, did that have also obviously weigh in on it with the fact that there's sort of a waning fan support?
I think there's a lot of factors. I think that's a factor. I mean, you have to, this is a business. We have to look at what's happened to our season ticket base over the last several years, and you can make projections on that and what it will cost you if you continue to do things the same way. I think it's a factor. It's not the only factor.
What's ideal for you? Is there a target hiring date? A time that you hope to have this wrapped up?
Well, like I said, I don't think we'll get our entire candidate pool until after the last game of the season. That could be after the last regular season or after championship week the week before. What I would like to do is either the week after the championship game or the week after the regular season, we do our interviews, and hopefully within, 10 days, the two to three weeks, we wrap it up by.
That'd be by the end of the year, calendar year?
That would be a fair goal. Hopefully we can exceed that, but it's more important to get the right person than someone about 10 days earlier.
Let me ask you, who is the right person for a job like this? It's a challenging job.
Yeah, I'm aware of challenging jobs. I think the right person for this has to have an affinity for Hawaii and an understanding of who we are. It does not mean they need to be from here, but I think they have to demonstrate that they have an appreciation for some of the our greatest blessings and our greatest challenges are sometimes the same thing. Our geography is a challenge, but it's who defines us too. I think a lot of energy. They're going to have to be willing to work harder than anyone else. We're not going to compete by not working harder. We got to work harder and smarter. I think those are some characteristics amongst some other ones.
All right, U.S. Athletics Director David Matlin addressing the media today. Norm Chow, former head coach of the UH football team, addressed his team just moments ago. We heard from Ben Clarke, one of the captains. David Matlin being very ginger in his words and very careful in his words as the selection process begins. The application process is underway. It is a five-day window, but the truth of the matter, we just heard from Mr. Matlin, this will probably be rolled over and extended because they want the best person for the job. There are limitations. Number one, money.
Right.
We want the best candidate. How much can we afford?
Right.
Yeah.
But also has to be somebody who likes Hawaii,
right.
Understands Hawaii, not necessarily from here.
Good question by Jai Kanaan, because at the end of the day, that will be a very critical component onto who Matlin decides upon. He's probably his biggest hire of his career.
Be interesting to watch this.
Yeah.